Fanatics, Crazy Russian Dead here, and like I have this song stuck in my brain. My older boy played it for me the other day, and it was like, you don't owe me, I am not one of your many toys. What is this, you don't owe me? I don't know, is it like IRS singing? It's like, 1044 is not for you. And I know I shouldn't be singing, I don't have the voice or the musical ear. The rest of the song is like rap, and I find rap crap. Oh, that sounded like crap. Yo, I am Crazy Russian Dead, and I don't like your rap, it's crap. Was that rappy? Probably not. You know what gets stuck in my brain? Like, you will not believe this, or maybe you will believe this, but like the old Soviet songs. And I know that the regime was evil, and I know that the songs were mainly propaganda. Oh, it's so sunny, unbelievable. But I still cannot get it out of my brain, like,
Рождённые веют над нами, тёмные силы нас злобно гнетут в бой роковой.
You know, and you know the rest, if you're from Russia or studied history or whatever. And like, I don't know, when I'm old in the nursing home with Alzheimer's, I probably won't remember anything, but I will probably still remember the stupid song. How do I get it out of my brain? Don't know. I mean, the only thing I can do, okay, is the sun pisses me off. Even though it's better than snow.
Наверх вы, товарищи, все по местам. Последний парад наступает. Врагу не сдается наш гордый варяг.
But that's not Soviet, actually. That's pre-Soviet. Anyway, whatever you heard in the childhood, you remember. At least I remember. I suppose I could try to put new words towards it. Like,
I'm driving to work in my Toyota Camry. I'm driving and stuck in traffic. I'm driving pissed off that I'm stuck in the traffic. Who knows when I'll make it to work.
Ooh, I don't know how opera singers sing so much. I almost passed out and lost my conscience. But I know I shouldn't sing. I already said that. But like, imagine, if you're embarrassed for me, imagine how my children must feel. I mean, that's why they never watch my channel. It's because they are... Oh, we're in the tunnel.
We are in the tunnel, but fear you not. We will come out of the tunnel on the other side.
That's what I mean. So anyway, my children are embarrassed, mortified. I would die if my father would do something this stupid, okay? And like, sort of, probably their friends are making fun of them, and then their teachers. Oh yeah, that's actually funny. When I go for these, like, this joke of meetings that they call parent-teacher conferences, like where I get 2 minutes, like speed dating, and maybe I get 5 minutes with a teacher, okay? Because they know I'm this famous Crazy Russian Dead. When I ask how is my child doing, they're like, everything is fine, please let them relax, don't give them any more homework, let them have ice cream. I'm like, listen, I'm just asking, please give me some status, you know, like give me some crap so I can give them crap at home. They assume I'm some kind of crazy person. Okay, I'm not crazy, I mean, but they're telling me what kind of parent to be. Like, I don't tell them to the face, at least, how to be a good teacher. I think they're doing a good job. They just need to be tougher on those little rascals, at least on my children. The rest of the children, they can relax. But they're telling me, like, I need to back off and I need to not to be so hard on my children. I'm not hard on my children. They have not met my father, okay? They have not met my dad, okay? If you want to meet somebody who's hard on a child, just, like, look at me, okay? I mean, everything I accomplished in life, I owe to my dad. Okay, like all the success, because my IQ is room temperature, my willpower does not exist, and yet I accomplished all this. Like, look at this luxury, okay? Look at this Toyota Camry, people, okay? That's the power of education and power of parenting. Good night.